In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I speak.
奉主耶稣圣名在这边说话。
Thank God for giving us this opportunity, that we are able to gather here in His presence to worship Him.
我们感谢神赐给我们在座所有人，大家让有这样的机会，一起在他的面前敬拜他。
And I always feel that being able to assemble in His presence is indeed His grace for us.
那么我深信。也深深的相信呢，能够在神的面前一起聚集敬拜他，这是一种恩典。
Because we are able to gather here to listen to His word.
因为我们能够一起在这里听他的话语。
And we know that His word is effective on those who believe in Him.
我们都知道，凡是信的人就有效果。
So we find that the word can transform our life.
我们都知道，他的话呢，能够改变我们的生活。
And can change our characters and behavior.
改变我们的生命，改变我们的行为，改变我们的想法。
And so we hope that by gathering here to worship God, our life can once again be transformed.
因此呢，能够在这边一起敬拜神，来听他的话语，让我们的生命再度更新。
Today I'm going to share with you something which is commonly spoken.
那么今天要跟大家一起来分享的一段经节是大家所熟悉的。
That is, the first will be last.And the last first.
也就是在前的要在后，在后的要在前。
This is a statement uttered by our Lord Jesus Christ on many occasions.
我们都知道这句话呢是主耶稣基督所讲的，而且在许多地方都说过这句话。
We can see this in the Gospels.
我们当然可以在福音书里面常看到。
I want you to turn to the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 19.
我们请大家一起翻开马太福音第十九章。
Gospel of Matthew, chapter 19.
马太福音第十九章。
Let's read the last verse, verse 30.
我们看到最后一节，也就是第三十节。
Matthew, chapter 19, verse 30.
马太福音第十九章第三十节。
But many who are first will be last, and the last first.
然而有许多在前的将要在后，在后的将要在前。
What exactly is Jesus talking about here?
我们看主耶稣基督到底想要在这里说什么。
If we read from verse 16 all the way to the end of the chapter,
如果我们从这一章的第十六节一直看到最后一节的话，
we begin to understand that here Jesus Christ is not talking about rank or position.
我们都知道主耶稣在整段的经节里面不是讲到地位或阶级。
For example, you know, today I'm a servant of God. I actively involved in church work.
比如说，我今天是神的仆人，我很积极地参与教会的一些工作。
To many of you, I am like a frontline worker of the church.
也许在大家眼里面，对教会而言，我好像在前线的工人一样。
Let's say after 15 years, I reach my retirement age.
15年之后，也许我已经到达退休的年纪。
So I decide to, you know, to get involved with less active works in the church.
也许在那个时候，我决定呢，比较少参与教会的一些前线的活动。
So that my work can be passed on to the younger generation.
因此，在我手中的工作就能够交接给下一代的青年。
To many of you.You may think that now I have, you know, like taking up some supporting roles in the church.
那么今天呢，大家会看到说我在教会里面担任很多支援的工作。
It's like I have become, you know, the last.
那么好像我已经是最后的了。
Actually, this is not what Jesus is saying.
在这里不是说主耶稣讲的这个道理。
You find that, you know, the statement of Jesus here is concerned with our salvation.
主耶稣在这边讲的整篇的道理，最主要是关心到我们每一个人得救的道理。
Let's look at verse 16, yeah, from verse 16 onwards.
我们从十六节开始看起。
Here it talks about a young person, a rich, a young ruler, came to Jesus.
在这边说到了一个年轻的官来见耶稣了。
So judging from the conversation between Jesus and the young man here, it seems.He is very interested in the issues of salvation.
这边我们看到这个年轻人跟耶稣的对谈当中，似乎这个人很关心自己未来得救与否啊。
It also seems that you know he had a very solid understanding of God.
那么从他的言语当中，他也非常的表现出他完全了解这位神。
And he is also a law-abiding believer of the Lord.
同样时间，他也是遵守神诫命的一个信徒。
Because when Jesus asked him,
因为呢，当主耶稣问他了，
Why do you call me good?
为什么你叫我是善的呢？
No one is good but one that is God.
这边说到，除了神以外，没有一个是良善的。
And Jesus said to him,
主耶稣说了，
but if you want to enter into life, keep the commandments.
这边说到，你若要进入永生，就是要当遵守诫命。
Now from his reply, it seems that he has kept all the commandments of God.
从他的回答当中，似乎他已经遵守了神许多的诫命。
So the Ten Commandments, he has kept them well.
包括了十诫，他已经遵守得非常完整。
So Jesus said to him.
所以主耶稣跟他说。
I want you to read verse 21.
我们看二十一节。
Chapter 19, verse 21.
同样这章十九章的第二十一节。
And Jesus said to him, "If you want to be perfect, go sell what you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. And come, follow me."
耶稣说：“你若愿意做完全人，可去变卖你所有的，分给穷人，就必有财宝在天上。你还要来跟从我啊！”
So by reading, you know, Matthew, it seems that Jesus was trying to be difficult.
从马太福音这样看起来呢，主耶稣好像为难这个年轻人。
How many of us actually can sell everything that we have and follow Jesus Christ?
我们在座的所有人，所有的人怎么能够变卖自己所有的一切去跟随耶稣呢？
It seems that the demand here Jesus imposed on him is difficult to carry out.
换句话，主耶稣告诉这个人该做的事情，这个年轻人很难做到啊。
At first reading is like, you know, the guy has to sell everything.And just follow Jesus.
这边我们一看一眼可以看得到，说这个人必须要变卖所有的，然后来跟耶稣。
Is that what Jesus is trying to say to him?
是不是真的就像主耶稣所说的这个表面的字意呢？
Now before we answer that question, I want you to continue to read on from verse 23.
在我们找到这个答案之前，我们继续看到二十三节。
So here Jesus said to his disciple.
耶稣对他的门徒说
Surely I said to you that it is hard for a rich man to enter the kingdom of heaven.
我实在告诉你们，财主进天国是难的。
Here Jesus uses a very simple illustration to explain his point to the disciples.
在这边主耶稣用了非常简单的字眼去告诉门徒他的意思。
Saying to them that it is easier for a camel to go through the eyes of a needle than for a rich man to enter the kingdom of God.
更加紧的来形容说，骆驼穿过针的眼呐、啊，比财主进天国更容易啊。
You know, in the ancient time, you know, whenever the city gate is shut,
我们都知道在古时候，当城门关了以后，
you find that you know those who let's say you know return late.Must enter by the side gate.
那些要晚上进城的人，必须要从城的边门进去。
So the side gates are called the needle.
所以这个
the eyes of the needle.
这个边门呢，这个城墙而言，就好像针眼一样。
Now you can imagine, you know, if a camel is heavily loaded with goods.
我们可以想象说，当一个骆驼驮着所有的货物的时候。
So if the main city gate is shut.
如果最主要的进城的大门已经关闭了。
It is impossible for the camel to enter.
当然就很难让载重的骆驼呢进入这个城。
Because with heavy load on the back,
因为它骆驼上面背得很重。
If the camel is to bend his legs and to go in,
那么骆驼就要压低自己的脚呢，为了要进去这个小门里。
Very likely, you know, the camel will snap his legs.
那么这么重的东西在背上呢，骆驼很容易折断他的腿的。
That's why Jesus said it is impossible, you know, for a rich man to enter into the kingdom of God.
所以主耶稣用这样来
，It's difficult to enter into the kingdom of God.
来说明说，财主要进天国，就好像骆驼穿针眼是一样的。
But Jesus also mentioned at the same time.
主耶稣再次强调
that with man this is impossible, but with God all things are possible.
在人是不能的，在神凡事都能的。
So you know, if you read verse 27, this is the reply or answer of Peter.
所以在看二十七节的时候，我们看到彼得怎么样回答。
Then Peter answered and said to him, "See, we have left all and followed you. Therefore, what shall we have?"
彼得就对他说：“看啊，我们已经撇下所有的跟从你了，将来我们要得什么呢？”
So if you look at the reply from Jesus Christ,
如果我们再看看主耶稣基督的回复
for those who have forsaken everything and to follow Christ,
凡是撇下所有的来跟从他的人呢
you find that even in this life he shall receive 100-fold.
那么就算在现今都要 得百倍啊。
Meaning that God will bless this person who has forsaken all things to follow Jesus.
换句话，神要祝福那些为了他撇下所有一切的人，跟随他的人。
So in the future, this person shall inherit eternal life.
所以在未来，这个人将要进入那永生啊。
So here we can see, you know, God is a fair God.
所以我们看到。神是一个公平的神。
Now coming back to the questions,
我们再回到刚才的问题。
Jesus asked this young man to sell everything that he has.
耶稣告诉这个少年人说，你要变卖一切。
And to ask him to follow Jesus Christ.
再下来你要来跟随主耶稣基督。
This is a very demanding, you know, request.
换句话，这是一个非常强烈的要求。
Why did Jesus do that?
为什么主耶稣要跟少年人这么说呢？
I want you to read Mark chapter 10.
我们请看到马可福音的第十章。
Please turn to the Gospel of Mark, chapter 10.
请翻到马可福音的第十章。
Mark chapter 10, from verse 17 onwards records the same incidents.
从十七节以下都记录同样刚才那样的对话。
But there are some variations that cannot be found in the Gospel of Matthew.
但是其中有一些对话呢，在马太福音却没有看到的。
I want you to read verse 21.
我们请大家一起看21节。
Mark chapter 10, verse 21.
马可福音第十章第21节。
Then Jesus, looking at him, loved him and said to him.
这边说到耶稣看着他就爱他，对他说。
One thing you lack.
你还缺少一样哦。
Go your way, sell whatever you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. And come, take up the cross and follow me.
去变卖你所有的，分给穷人，就必有财宝在天上。你还要来跟从我啊。
According to the writer of Mark,
这边说到了这个马可福音的作者这么说了。
Before Jesus demanded this young man to sell everything,
在主耶稣告诉这个少年人。变卖所有一切的之前
It's like Mark has observed that Jesus has done it out of love for this young man.
在马可的这个作家里面可以看得到说主耶稣真的说这句话是因为爱他。
It's not like Jesus was trying to be difficult.
不是要给他难题啊。
Actually, Jesus did this out of love for him.
这边说到说主耶稣跟他讲这句话是因为爱这个少年人。
In what way do you think that Jesus loved him?
我们怎么看说主耶稣爱他呢？
Now if we turn back to Matthew,
我们再看回马太福音。
We turn back to Matthew chapter 19.
我们看回马太福音的第十九章。
Matthew chapter 19.
马太福音第十九章。
Now we look at the reactions of this young man to the demand of Christ.
我们看看说这个少年人对主耶稣所讲的这段话之后的一个反应。
We read verse 22.
我们再看二十二节。
Chapter 19, verse 22.
十九章的第二十二节。
But when the young man heard that saying, he went away sorrowful, for he had great possessions.
那少年听见这话就忧忧愁愁地走了，因为他的产业很多啊。
So you find that he was not able to, like, you know, follow the order of Christ.
换句话呢，他无法来照主耶稣所说的来做。
Instead, the Bible says he went away sorrowful.
圣经告诉我们说，他忧忧愁愁地走了，离开了。
Why did he go away sorrowful?
为什么他这么忧愁地离开了呢？
The reason given is that because he had great possessions.
因为他的产业很多啊。
Outwardly, it seems that he is a law-abiding believer.
从刚开始一看的时候，确实他是真的很遵守神的命令的人。
Outwardly, it seems that he followed God's way.
从表面上看来，他真的是按照神的道理在走。
But we know that Jesus is God.
但是我们知道耶稣就是神。
He searches the hearts of men.
他看清楚人的心。
He knows what is in the hearts of men.
他知道人的心在想什么。
And Jesus wants to help him.
那么耶稣要帮助这个少年人。
That's why in the Gospel of Mark.
所以在马可福音。
We are told that Jesus loved the person.
我们看到刚才所读到的耶稣因为爱着他，所以跟他说这段话。
Without asking him to sell everything.
除了要求他变卖所有的一切
，You find that this young man can lose his salvation eventually.
我们可以看耶稣已经看到了，到最后这个年轻人进不了永生的。
Why? Because he treasured his own possession more than God.
因为呢，他看自己的产业重过于看神。
You find that this is a problem which is hidden in him.
换句话呢，这样的一个问题就藏在那少年人的心底。
But Jesus was able to see this very clearly.
但是主耶稣却能够看到这个少年人心底真正的问题在哪里。
That's why Jesus wanted to help him.
所以主耶稣因为爱他要帮他。
To help him solve this problem.
要帮他解决他心里最难的那个问题。
But we see that he refused helping from Christ.
我们看到这个少年人拒绝耶稣的帮助。
So as a result, he went away sorrowful.
因此他忧忧愁愁地走了。
It goes to show that his great possession actually is more important than Jesus.
换句话也就表现出他真的看产业比耶稣还重啊。
Sometimes when we look at ourselves,
有时候我们看看自己。
Hourly it seems that we are fine Christians.
从表面上看起来我们是一个遵守道理的基督徒。
Because we have been helping out with a lot of divine work in the church.
因为我们在教会里面常常帮着教会许多的圣工。
And we also observe the Sabbath and we come to the church to pray and offer.make offerings to God.
我们来教会祷告，来教会奉献，来遵守安息圣日。
It seems that we are good Christians.
看起来我们表面上真的是一个好的基督徒。
But sometimes we realize that there are actually some hidden shortcomings in our hearts.
但是有时候呢，在我们的心中的抵触呢是有缺陷的。
So we find that if all these shortcomings are not removed, are not corrected.
如果这些缺陷没有被铲除的话
they can cost us our salvation.
那么将我们付出的代价会失去永生的。
So you find that Jesus concluded by saying this.
所以主耶稣在这里下了一个结论啊。
And said it to the disciples.
而且把这个结论告诉给当在场的门徒。
But many who are first will be last and the last first.
所以他这边说到说在前的要在后，在后的要在前啊。
When you look at the young men,
我们看到年轻人
he believed in the Lord.
这个少年人信主
he followed God's commandments.
他跟随他遵守神的命令
he placed himself in the position of being the first.
他把他放在那就外表看起来真的是在众人的前面
because he has this hope of salvation.
因为他确实对这个永生有盼望
But when Jesus exposed his shortcoming,
但是当主耶稣显露出他的弱点的时候
and he begins to realize that actually he is far from having the salvation.
他才清楚认知说他离永生还太远的呢。
That's why he left Jesus Christ.
因此他就走了。
So today we are in the church of God.
今天我们来到神的家，神的教会。
We have been given salvation from the Lord.
我们已经因为恩典得到永生了。
So in the eyes of God, we are always the first.
所以在神的眼里面，我们是在前面的。
So we must make sure that we can maintain this position.
所以我们要能够很确认的这个前面的位置，我们一直要保持着。
We must not lose our salvation and becoming the last.
我们绝对不可以因为任何的原因，反而在前面变在后面了就永生而言。
Now when you look at the Gospel of Luke,
所以我们再看到路加福音的话
Luke.Speaks about many rich people.
路加福音当中谈到许多的有钱人，富有的人。
And one of them is this rich young person.
其中一个所谓的富有的人就是这位少年人。
We can see this in Luke chapter 18.
我们来看到路加福音十八章。
Chapter 18, verse 18, all the way to verse 30 talks about this young person.
路加福音第十八章第十八节开始，一直到三十节，就谈到了这个有钱的人，少年人。
But when you read chapter 19 here, it speaks of another rich person.
来到了第十九章，我们又看到另外一个富人。
And this person is called a Zacchaeus.
那这边看到了说，这叫做撒该呀。
Now I want to do a contrast between the two characters here.
那在这两章当中，我要跟大家比较一下这两个人物。
So when you read when you look at the young man,
当你看到这个少年人的时候
，probably he was born into the faith.
事实上，他也许在信仰里面生的。
He was taught from young to honor God and to respect God.
那么他在那样的生活里面生出来以后呢，他从小被教育说一定要信神，一定要靠神。
Probably he has gone through many times the law of Moses.
那么他好像他可能已经读了圣经，读了好多次了。
But when you look at this Zacchaeus,
当我们来到了第十九章，看到这个撒该呀。
Probably he was an old person.
撒该也许是个年纪大的人。
Because he was a tax collector.
这边说到他是个税吏长啊。
So he is the chief, yeah.
而且说是个不但是税吏的官员，而且是税吏长啊。
So he must have, been working for a long period of time, before he can reach that level.
既然来到了税吏长，在政府的官员里面，他似乎一定要到相当大的年纪才能够到那样的地位嘛。
But you see that after his conversion，
但是我们看到他信主之后，
He was a changed person altogether。
那么他完全改变成另外一个人。
We can see this marked change in his thinking。
我们可以看到这个改变是在他的想法当中、态度当中改变。
I want you to read chapter 19。
我们请看第十九章。
We read from verse 8。
我们从八节开始。
Chapter 19, verse 8。
十九章第八节。
Then Jacob stood and said to the Lord, "Look, Lord, I give half of my goods to the poor, and if I have taken anything from anyone by false accusation, I restore fourfold."
撒该站着对主说：主啊，我把所有的一半给穷人，我若讹诈了谁，就还他四倍。
We know that, you know, tax collectors in the scriptures, they are like outcasts of the society.
我们都知道在圣经当中，当形容到税吏的时候，这等于是这个社会的边缘人一样啊。
They are rejected by the society because they were deemed like, thieves, or extortioners.
换句话，他被这个社会所排斥，因为呢，社会看他们就好像小偷一样，专门拿钱的。
They were greedy people in the eyes of the society.
而且在社会人的眼中呢，他们好像是很贪心的人。
So in fact, that is true.
事实上，他们也真的是这样啊。
So to them, money is very important.
所以换句话，对一个税吏来讲呢，钱是最重要的。
Because they all greed for wealth.
因为呢，他们就是要贪财而富有啊。
But after the conversion of Zacchaeus,
但是在撒该信主之后
，you find that he make a very clear declaration, like not only to himself.But to the people around him.
我们看到他信主之后，他不但对外宣称，跟众人宣称，也像主这样来宣称。
This is to make clear to the people.
他来宣告，让大家能够看得清楚。
And also to tell himself.
而且对他自己也是一个宣言。
That after his conversion, he will no longer look highly upon money.
换句话，在他信主之后，他不再把钱看为最重的。
Money is no longer his God.
换句话，钱已经不在他心中的神了。
Now, if you look at verse 8 again,
我们再看八节一次。
You know, I'm thinking to myself.
我有时候这样自己想啊。
If he were to give half of his goods to the poor,
如果他把他的一半给了穷人
，and to restore fourfold to them whom he has cheated,
而且说到如果他骗了谁，就能够赔他四倍的话
most likely he will become a beggar.
那么这样的结果呢，他一定到时候分文都没有了。
Now what does it tell us about?
在这里这一节告诉我们什么
？Money was God to him before.
Yes, 是的，钱对他来讲就好像以前的神一样。
But after his conversion,
但是在他信主之后
，he now honor God more than anything else.
他今天尊主为大，已经超过任何事情。
So we can say that he was last before.
所以可以看到说，他以前在众人的眼中，在主的面前他是最后的。
Now he is the first.
现在他在主的面前是在前面的。
Because he has obtained salvation and he looked highly upon salvation.
原因就是因为他已经得到这个救恩，而且重视这个救恩。
So on the contrary, when you look at the young man again,
所以相对的，我们看看刚才十八章讲的那个少年人。
Yes, he has been given grace first.
是的，他在一开始也许他就在人的前面。
But there was a hidden problem in him.
但是在他的心里面却有很大的一个缺陷。
If this problem is not resolved,
如果这样的缺点不解决的话
，he could become the last.
那么在神的永生前面，他就会是最后的。
Meaning he will lose his salvation.
换句话就是他要失去这个永生了。
If you look at ourselves today,
今天我们看看自己。
We say everyone has their own weaknesses or shortcomings.
每一个人都带有自己的软弱跟缺陷。
You know, whether we like it or not, because we are human beings, we always say to err is human.
不论我们自己喜不喜欢，因为我们就是人。
So to make mistake is human.
所以说人会犯错。
But we need to correct ourselves.
但是我们要懂得去纠正自己。
So when we examine ourselves.
所以当我们反省自己的时候
，When we see our own shortcomings，
当我们看到自己的软弱的地方的时候
，We must not ignore them。
我们不可以就这么忽略它。
And we cannot say we just live with our shortcomings。
我们不可以说因为我是人嘛，所以就有软弱喽。
And this is not right。
这个是不对的观念。
Sometimes in our heart there may be an element of uncleanness。
也许在我们的心中的抵触就有这么一点点不洁净的元素。
So if we do not cleanse it out。
换句话，如果我们不把它洁净的话
，you find that we are in danger of losing our salvation。
换句话，我们已经落在那失去永生的危险当中了。
Why when temptation arises？
所以当诱惑来到的时候
，we may not be able to resist temptation。
我们因为自己的软弱，没有办法去抵抗这样的诱惑。
Because there is no power on our part。
原因是因为在我们这边，我们失去了力量。
Why? Because we allow this uncleanness to develop in our heart。
原因就是因为我们让那小小的不洁净元素在心中成长了。
So when temptation comes，
所以当诱惑来了
，we shall fall。
我们就会跌倒的。
That is the reason why we must be very careful with ourselves。
换句话，也就是说，我们为什么说要自己要很警？
You know, when we look at our life, yeah.
有时候我们看到自己的生活。
I always say to myself.
我常常告诉自己。
And I also encourage our brothers and sisters.
我也常常这样子来勉励弟兄姐妹。
We must look highly upon, you know, the services arranged by the church.
所以我们常常要很重视教会所安排的服事啊。
Services
聚会。
So.Everyone must do their best to come to attend church services.
换句话，凡是教会有聚会的时候，大家都要尽力来参加。
If we do not show any keen interest in attending church services,
换句话，当我们不再重视、不再感兴趣教会的聚会的时候
，we find that this fervency or zeal will begin to decline.
我们会看到那热心的程度呢，就继续的降低了。
If our zeal for God declining,
如果我们对神热心的程度持续降低
，then quite clearly our knowledge of God will decline as well.
那么相对的，我们对神的认识就会越来越少。
So when that happens in our life,
如果那样的情况在我们的生命里面发生了
，for example, when we become very busy,
比如说我们开始忙碌了
，then we'll stop attending church services altogether.
我们因为生活一忙，我们就完全不愿意来教会了。
So you can imagine what will happen to us if we stop.Coming to the church to worship God.
所以我们可以想见说，如果我们不再来教会敬拜神的话
，our spiritual life will wither away.
那么我们属灵的生命将渐渐枯萎了。
And then we will not have life in us.
那么到最后我们就没有那属灵的生命在我们里面了。
Not showing interest in coming to church to observe the Sabbath.It's a weakness.
换句话，如果不感兴趣，对安息日完全不感开始不感兴趣的话，这就是一个弱点的开始。
So we need to correct it.
换句话，我们要懂得去纠正它。
We pray to God for help.
我们求神来帮助我们。
In the eyes of many, this may seem to be negligible, something that we can forget about it.
也许我们在很多事情看起来这小小的，也许哎没关系啦。
But if we are not careful, it can kill us.
如果不小心的话，这一旦长成了会。置我们于死地的。
So we must be very careful with ourselves.
所以换句话，对自己的灵命要非常的警醒啊。
Now another example.
另外一个例子。
We know that the Bible teaches us to be forgiving towards one another.
我们都知道，圣经一直教导我们要原谅，要宽恕别人。
I'm not too sure about the church here.
那不晓得这里的教会怎么样子。
You know the churches that I look after.
那么我在照顾的教会那里呢
？Sometimes we see that you know.Certain churches they have a lot of problems.
我们都知道，有些教会呢，中间都有一些某些的问题存在。
We realize that many of the problems actually stem from the fact that you know many of the members you know, are not being able to forgive.
那么我们都知道，这样的有时候可以看得到，这样的问题呢，都是因为弟兄姐妹当中呢，没有办法表现，没有办法做到宽恕的心。
So we can come up with a lot of reasons for not forgiving.
那不能够宽恕别人，总是有理由。
But the Bible tells us.
但是圣经怎么说
？And in fact, the Bible does not give any reasons for us to forgive.
圣经告诉我们说，要能够完完全全的饶恕，不带理由、不带条件的饶恕。
So our forgiving of others must be unconditional.
换句话，我们饶恕别人必须是完全无条件式的。
Sometimes when we read the Bible, we feel that this is too hard to do.
有时候我们看到这节，我们会觉得说，开玩笑，这个太难了。
How can I do that? Look at that guy. He has been harming me all the time.
我怎么能做得到？你看那个弟兄对我这么坏。
Because he always offend me.
而且他常常得罪我。
He speak ill against me.
而且他在我背后说坏话。
How can I forgive this person?
这样的人我怎么能够饶恕？
But we realize that if we do not make an effort to forgive,
但是如果我们不努力朝这个方向去，
we find that this being unforgiving can cause us to depart from God.
那么这样饶恕的心做不出来的时候，我们会离神开始越来越远。
You know why? When we come to the church,
你知道为什么吗？当我们来到教会，
if there is a grudge between us and others.
如果我们跟弟兄姐妹有所过节的话
，you find that coming to church is a burden。
那么来到教会，大家会觉得说这是一种负担呢、啊。
Because we want to avoid seeing that person.
原因就是因为不想见到这个人呐、啊。
So you know, sometimes when we come to the church, we look right and look left to make sure that the person is not around.
有时候我们来到
before we go to that place.
有时候我们来到教会的时候，坐下之前会看看谁有没有在我的旁边，因为呢不想看到这样的人嘛。
You find that this is a burden.
你会觉得说这样的是一个。是一个重担。
We said coming to church should be a joyous thing.
我们都知道来到教会应该是最喜乐才对啊。
So when we are able to forgive,
所以我们如果能够懂得宽恕人，
we find that coming to church is a joy.
所以我们就知道说来到教会真的是喜乐、啊。
We enjoy coming to the church.
换句话，来到教会真的能够得到真正的喜乐。
If you feel burdened in coming to the church,
如果来到教会却变成我的负担，
it means that there is something wrong within us.
换句话呢，在我的心里面已经有状况了。
We have to do something about it to correct ourselves.
对这样的问题，对这样的状况，我们要从心里面把它修正过来。
Sometimes when we visit members who have not been coming to the church,
有时候我们去弟兄姐妹家，很久没来教会的弟兄姐妹家。
And we realize one of the common reasons is because, you know, there are misunderstandings in the church.
在看过的这些例子当中呢，最普遍的就是呢，大家互相的误会。
So you find that this thing actually can kill.
我们看到哈。人跟人之间误会，事实上是会伤人的。
So you know, we may have already obtained salvation.
是的，我们已经真的得到了主所赐恩典的永生。
But if we are not being able to forgive,
但是如果我们不懂得去饶恕别人
，we can fall from being the first to being the last.
那么我们就会从前面掉到后面啦。
This happened to many of us already.
那么在我们在座的很多人其实都发生过这样的情况。
That's why we need to correct.Our shortcomings in life.
换句话，在我们的生命当中，我们要懂得修正自己的缺点。
There's one more point I want to bring to your attention.
那么再一点跟大家来分享的。
We know that the truth is very important to the church.
我们都知道教会带有真理啊，非常重要的。
We are saved because of the truth.
我们因为真理而得救啊。
You know, sometimes I go to Pioneer area.
有时候我到一些开拓区啊
，We preach the basic belief of the church.
那么我们将教会的基本信仰传给那边的人。
Sometimes you find that you know these people that come over to the True Jesus Church.
我们看到有些人来到真耶稣教会。
Precisely because they believe that what the TJC preaches is correct.
那么他们真正相信的就是因为真耶稣教会所传的道理是真的。
Not only that, when they pray to God, they receive the Holy Spirit.
所以因为这样的信心，他们到跪下祷告就得到圣灵。
You know, the truth of the church is very precious.
所以教会的真理是非常的宝贵。
So all of us must honor the truth.
换句话，我们都要真的能够尊敬这样的真理啊。
We must make sure that we know what we believe in.
我们必须要能够确认而且认识自己信的是什么。
We cannot take it for granted.
我们绝对不可以太草率啊。
I always believe in the church there is only one set of belief.
我总是相信在教会里面只有一个信仰。
This is what Paul has taught us about.
这也就是保罗在圣经里面告诉我们的。
One faith.
也就是一信啊。
In the early church, there is only one faith.
在早期的时代的教会只有一信啊。
So in the true Jesus church.
那么在真耶稣教会里呢？
There is only one set of belief.
也就是只有一套基本信仰。
This is something that we must bear in mind.
那么这个我们一定要牢牢记在心里。
If you take it very lightly,
如果我们只是很草率、很轻视的信它而已
，thinking that this set of belief is only, you know, like man-made,
那么这套信仰呢，也许只是人造的而已。
Because every Christian denomination also have their own sets of belief.
因为其他的基督教派都有他们一套的信仰嘛。
Why should I pay so much attention to the basic belief of the church?
为什么我要对真耶稣教会所传的基本信仰真道这么的重视？
I want you to read the passage.
我请大家看一节圣经。
Return to 1 Corinthians chapter 15.
我们请看哥林多前书第十五章。
1 Corinthians chapter 15.
哥林多前书第十五章。
We can read from verse 1.
我们从第一节看起。
1 Corinthians chapter 15.
哥林多前书第十五章。
We read verse 1.
第一节。
Moreover, brethren, I declare to you the gospel which I preached to you, which also you received, and in which you stand.
弟兄们，我如今把先前所传给你们的福音告诉你们知道，这福音你们也领受了，也靠着站立得住。
Verse 2.
第二节。
By which also you are saved, if you hold fast that word which I preached to you, unless you believe in vain.
并且你们若不是 突然相信，能以持守我所传给你们的，就必因这福音得救。
Here Paul speak to the members in Corinth.
这边保罗跟哥林多教会的弟兄姐妹这样说。
Concerning the manner in which they have received the gospel.
这边说到说他们已经领受了福音。
So by receiving the gospel, they are able to stand firm in the Lord.
既然领受了，就要在能够主的面前站立得住。
And Paul also says, by that gospel, you are saved.
这边说到说，也因为这个福音，你们要得救啊。
If you hold fast that word which he preached to them，
那么也就是说，要能够持守我所传给你们的这福音呢、啊。
Now they have received the gospel。
是的，他们已经得到福音了。
They are given this grace of salvation。
那么他们也因为恩典得到永生了。
It's like they are being the first in the eyes of God。
换句话，在神的面前，似乎他们就是在前面了。
And here Paul said to them。
保罗就说了
that they must hold on to the gospel to the end.
保罗告诉他们要持守到最后啊。
Unless you believe in me.
那么你要坚信到底啊。
You know, otherwise your faith will be in vain.
换句话呢，要不然的话，这个福音对你来说就白费枉费了。
You will lose your salvation because if you forsake the gospel.
你如果离弃了这个真道，换句话，也就离开了永生啊。
So this is very important to us as well.
这对我们来说非常重要哦。
I always believe in this.
我一直都相信这一点。
Because today we have received the Holy Spirit.
今天我们领受了圣灵。
It testified to us that the truth that the church preaches is correct.
换句话，也为我们所领受到的这个教会的真理做见证。
Sometimes we go to Africa and we ask our workers there.
有时候我们到非洲哈，问那边问在那边的工人
，Why do you come to the True Jesus Church？
问他说你为什么来到真耶稣教会
？In the True Jesus Church, you are not paid。
那么在真耶稣教会工作，你是没钱的，没有钱的。
In your formal church, you are paid. You were paid。
那么在你过去那个教会呢，你是有钱赚的。
Why do you come over to the True Jesus Church？
那么什么理由让你来到真耶稣教会呢
？They will say to you，
他们会这样回答哦。
Because of the truth。
因为真理。
Because in the True Jesus Church, I receive the Holy Spirit.
因为在真耶稣教会，我得到圣灵。
I'm convinced by the truth, and I am convinced by the Holy Spirit.
换句话，我绝对相信这得到的圣灵，我绝对相信所传的真道。
So today we have already received the Holy Spirit.
今天我们都领受了那宝贵圣灵。
Therefore we know that the truth that the church preaches is correct.
因此我们可以很确认的知道这个教会所传的真理是正确的。
Because we know that the Spirit is the truth, and the truth is the Holy Spirit.
我们都知道这真理就是真理的圣灵，这个圣灵就是真理。
So if we hold on to the truth,
换句话，如果我们持守住这个真道，
when confusion and deception comes,
当一些扰乱纷争来的时候，
we will not be swept away.
我们不会因为这样的欺骗而被带走了。
Because we are serious about the gospel.
原因就是因为我们非常重视这真理。
We are very serious about the belief that we have held on to.
换句话，我们很重视我们所持守之道啊。
You know, for those who are very serious about the gospel.
换句话说，从心里面真的看重这个信仰、这个福音的话。
Those who treasure the truth.
换句话，能够很珍惜这样的真理。
We find that God will guide these people.
我们会看到、神真的带领这群人。
You guide these people in times of deception and in times of confusion.
神会带领这样坚信道理的人，通过那不明不白或是弯曲悖谬的时代。
Because God loves this kind of people.
原因是因为神爱这样爱道理的人。
So we hope that all of us can, you know, develop this love for the gospel.
所以换句话，大家都能够产生对真理，爱的心。
I want you to read one more verse.
我们跟大家一起再读一段经节。
Second Thessalonians.
我们请看帖撒罗尼迦后书。
Chapter two.
第二章。
Second Thessalonians chapter two.
帖撒罗尼迦后书的第二章
we read verse 10.
第二章的第十节
Second Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 10.
帖撒罗尼迦后书第二章第十节
And befall unrighteous deceptions among those who perished because they did not receive the love of the truth that they might be saved.
并在那沉沦的人身上行各样出于不义的诡诈，因为他们不领受爱真理的心，使他们得救。
Here it talks about the love of the truth.
这里告诉我们说，那爱真理的心呢、啊、
？They did not have this love of the truth.
换句话，这些人没有这样的心呢、啊、
？So as a result, God is like, you know, give them up altogether.
所以结论也就是神真的把他们放弃了。
So allow this, you know, strong delusion to come upon them.
所以让那个不义的诡诈就沉沦在他们身上。
So that they should believe the lie and not the gospel of God anymore.
换句话，他们就信从了那个不义的诡诈，已经不爱真理了。
So today we are the first in terms of the gospel of salvation.
所以今天我们在得救的真理面前，我们是在前的。
Because we have received the grace of God.
原因就是因为我们得到神所赐的恩典啊、
But we have to ensure that we will not lose this gospel of salvation.
但是我们要能够非常的坚定确认，我们不要失去了这永生啊。
To do that, we must be serious about our belief.
那么为了要做到这样的事情，确认这样的事情，我们必须要看重自己的信仰。
We must even need to pray to God to make sure that we can keep this truth that we have received from the church.
我们要向神祷告，让我们很确认的保守我们真的领受到的真理。
We sing a hymn.
我们一起唱诗。
150.
150首。